Hey guys, I just wanted to give you a rundown and some tips and tricks on how to use the product tracker. So firstly, there are two ways to add products to the tracker. You can do that by adding the ASIN or the URL. So over here at Amazon, you can add either by the URL, or you can come down here and copy the ASIN. Paste it in and add to tracker. So after you first add a product, it takes 2 days to generate sales data. It doesn't give you historic data as it tracks in real time, starting from the date that you add it. You have the ability to create categories so that you can sort the products however you'd like. Come over here, you can create your own. So let's take a look at this product. We've been tracking it for a while now, and you can change the date range that you want to look at between 7 and 60 days. So you can see here the number of inventory for that day, the units sold, the BSR rank, and the buy box price. The axes for the number of units is here on the left, and the axes for the bestseller rank is over here on the right. And then the green line here indicates how the BSR ranking changes each day. Let's look at another example. You'll see that there's two colors here, orange and black. The black data represents the actual number of units sold. This is calculated by taking the inventory from this day and the inventory from this day and subtracting the difference. If the seller happens to have more than 999 units in stock, then Amazon doesn't tell us the exact number of inventory in stock, and therefore what we do is that we estimate the units sold on that particular day, is what the orange color represents. But then you see as their inventory level comes down below 1,000, we're then able to calculate the real data again, represented by the black. The other time that this might occur is when the buy box seller for that particular day changes. So because the number of inventory changes, that then means that we can't calculate the exact sales for that particular day, and so we estimate the sales instead. So what you might see is a number of black bars, and then one day orange, and then back to black bars again. So then over here on the right, you've got additional details about the product. Now above each product, you've got the average price, rank, units sold per day, and revenue. Again, just to recap some of the earlier points, you can add your product up here, create categories to sort them, take your products here and you can drag them around. So let's say you even wanted to move this product into a new category, you can do it there and it'll update for you. Click down here to analyze the data, view additional information, and that's about it. I hope you guys have enjoyed this tutorial and good luck with your product research.